Hello. My name is Sergey. I'm from Russia. I know what you're thinking. These Russians. They're good looking. Cultured. Honest and peace-loving people. But you may have noticed we are in the news recently. For other things. Poison, war, hacking, doping, no different combination. But don't believe it. Just don't. It is all fake news. And I know what I'm talking about. We Russians, we are the best in producing fake news. And we do it very, very efficiently. We just take facts, speak them out with Russian accent, and it becomes fake news. Announced. The climate change is coming. We will all die. Someday. And prompt reaction from Western media. Be aware. Every time you hear about global warming or climate change, Russians could be behind it. Don't believe it. Fake news. But you know, I don't want to talk to you about Russian fake news, or Russian war, Russian poisoning. No. I want to talk to you about Russia and unconditional love. I mean, your unconditional love to Russia. Every human being wants unconditional love. Even animals want love. As you know, recently Trump called Assad an animal. He said Assad is an animal. But he didn't mean it insulting. No. Ask scientists. They say every living being on Earth is a plant or an animal. So if I say, you're not a plant, what is insulting about it? I think, actually, Trump wanted to say something nice to Assad. Assad read it. Assad is an animal. Collected his generals and said proudly, look, the Americans, they do respect me. He knows that Assad means a lion in Arabic. What a well-read, intelligent man this guy. And they do respect each other. But I feel sorry for people who abuse power. A couple of times I worked with young criminals here in Berlin. I coached them. I worked with them as an anti-aggression trainer. Not helping them to become better criminals. And all of them, really all of them, had a victim experience in the past. I bet Putin had a tough childhood too. He was one of the smallest in the class. Maybe he was offended by his schoolmates and even teachers. You tiny loser! You will become nothing! Get out of here! You will get your punishment in the director's office. And that is where he is, Putin. Till this time, in the director's office. So just be careful what you say to people. And now imagine, you are Putin, the president of the Soviet Union, I mean the Russian Federation. Not yet. presidential election, and you have a strong feeling that you could win this time again. And Football World Cup in Russia is coming, and you think, how can I improve rapidly my image on the world stage? I know. I will kill a secret agent abroad. First, it is my former agent. So I have the whole authority to kill him. We are free country. He betrayed me 30 years ago. Yeah. I'm not resentful, no. But it was already 30 years of my to-do list. And I think it's a good time to do it right now. Yeah. Talking about to-do lists. My wife is German. And she's a real German. From the West German. Not this Russian-like former Eastern. And my three kids are German too. So it's 4-1 in our family. I'm a clear minority. But when we are invited by our German friends, they all shout, "Hey, the Russians are coming!" And the traditional Russian tea ceremony begins. Yeah, it's just the same as a Japanese tea ceremony. No, just the same, with a slight difference. We don't drink tea. No, we tried. We tried with tea first. But you know, after 5 shots of tea and pancakes. Nothing really happened. So we changed the procedure. And it ends as it always ends right now. With a soft classical Russian music.
It is 100% the same as marketing.
100%. He's a marketing god. No, you just focus on the positive side of your product and miss all the unnecessary alternative factors. Yeah, and we Russians, we try to learn it from market leaders. Are you looking for a new family vehicle? Do you want to drive secure and without any traffic jam? We have a perfect solution for you. Russian modern tank, Armada T-14. Your neighbors will respect you again. And you can get your money back soon. Yeah, but the best marketing strategy to compete evil competitors is called preventive retaliation. Or preventive revenge. Just attack someone as an act of defense. You know how it works? Is someone married here? Okay. So you come home after a long working day, you are tired, you want to relax, open the door, yeah, and your wife shouts at you, "You are divorced, man! Before you even think to betray me, you son of a bitch." But it doesn't help. What we really need is love and kindness. So starting right now, right here, let's make love, not war, Russian style. I'm Sergey. Thank you for being under my influence. Good night and sleep tight.